G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, now that we've plotted our long section and worked out the slope of our trench, and we've got that worked out, I'm now going to go through a couple of ways of actually calculating firstly the area of this shape and then the volume. So we've done our long section, we've ended up with all this, you know, this is the natural surface of the ground, this is the bottom of the trench. And we know these heights along the way, so we have all these different depths of our trench. So basically we've got all these areas, looks like that. And as I said, we know how long these are, and we know how deep they are all the way along. So there are three different ways of working out the area. I'm going to show you probably the simplest way first in this video, and then in the next video I'll show you the more accurate, but a little bit harder way of doing it. So this is what we're going to call the average depth method. So all we're going to do is we're going to take the average of all these depths, times it by the length of the trench, and that'll give us a rough estimation of how much material or the area of this trench is. Okay, so using average depth. So the length, the entire length of the trench, times by the sum of all the heights. So we add all these together, and then we divide it by however many heights there are. So in this case, it's 11, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So the length of our trench is 50 metres, and all our different heights are in there, so we add them together, and then we divide by 11. So all our heights added together give us 9.838 metres, divided by 11 gives us 0.989 as an average depth across that trench, times that by 50, and that gives us 44.781 square meters of trench. Okay, and obviously if we then wanted to add the make that area, turn that into a volume, you would times that by the width of the trench. Now what I've shown you here is what we've effectively done is we've turned these shapes into trapezoids. So this curve that we had on the original ground, we haven't considered. Our calculation basically cuts that section of ground off in a straight line from this height to this height. So we haven't calculated this little bit above the ground and on our other shapes. Okay, again, we've just gone straight from that point to that point. So that's a straight line on top there. So we actually haven't allowed for that ground that's not there. We've actually overcalculated on this one. So there's a little bit of two and give and take with this calculation, and that's why it's not spot on as far as accuracy goes. Okay, so that's the average depth method. In the next video, I'll go through a method that'll give us a little bit more accurate calculation because it'll actually allow for the curve of the ground.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.